We are in downtown Manhattan, New York, to talk precision combat training with the reigning Bellator Mixed Martial Arts Light Heavyweight Champion, Britain's Liam McGeary.
MMA is mixed martial arts, all mixed together, all in one cage. You have kickboxing, Muay Thai, boxing, karate, then most of your stand-up martial arts, and then you have the ground game, which will be jiu-jitsu, wrestling, judo. You have to work on every single martial art, and you have to get everything perfect. You don't want to go into war with only one or two weapons. You want to go in with a whole arsenal. It's all about getting your body to that pinnacle point of when you're fighting, and you have to be ready for that day.
McGeary left the UK in 2012 to pursue his dream of winning an MMA world title. A truly meteoric rise through the ranks saw him become light heavyweight champion of the prestigious Bellator promotion in less than 3 years. And he has an unblemished record of 11 wins, 0 draws, 0 losses.
This guy's the real deal, you know, he's one of those special fighters that just knows how to fight. He's got natural talent, he's got power like you wouldn't believe. And you see him get in the ring and he shines, and it's like, you know, you couldn't ask for more. That's exactly what you want in a fighter.
The relationship a fighter has with their coach is a very close one. It can almost be like a father and son relationship where you look to this guy for protection, you look to him for advice, and you look for him to teach you.
He's developing, and I still think there's a lot more for him to learn. You know, he's already a dangerous individual, and I think he can become more dangerous. It's like building a car. You know, okay, see, I got a fast car. I can make it faster. I can make it handle better. I can make it faster and more efficient. I feel like that's what I'm doing with Liam. You know, I can't wait for the final product. It's gonna be amazing.
It's the most disciplined sport you'll ever come across. In a basic week of training, I could spend every day with Jason. I know I have to be out of bed in the gym on the mat for 7:30 to do my lessons, and then I'll carry on training right away throughout the day. Jiu-jitsu classes, wrestling classes, strength and conditioning classes, sparring sessions.
I just kind of work on just fine-tuning everything, so we kind of just break things down a little bit and focus on one thing one day and maybe another thing another day, and then kind of put it all together, and it just kind of flows and it just becomes one thing. It just becomes a masterpiece.
The perfect punch needs to be precise on the button. It's really not about how hard you can hit. You have to be that accurate with your shot, and there's a little button here and a little soft spot on the side of the face. You just catch that nice with enough pressure, flash knockout, and then a referee steps in.
You know, with Liam, we just try to get the most out of him without him expending too much energy, you know, because he's a big guy, and big guys have a tendency to, you know, get tired faster, and the technique goes out the window. So I really try to focus on breaking everything down with Liam with the punch, like body positioning, weight positioning from the leg up, where to twist the shoulder, where to twist the hip, where to turn the hand over right at the end, what part of the hand to hit with, and, you know, just maximizing the power.
I have to get my shots precise. I have to make sure they're accurate, and I know where I'm throwing them. And that's where the focus mix comes in.
It just takes a lot of repetition, a lot of over and over and over. Maybe we'll work on the left hand, then we go back to the right hand, then we go back to the left hand, and then it just all of a sudden becomes natural, and then right at the end, he's turning it over perfect. And in the fight, it just comes out like it's supposed to, and, you know, lights out.
Everything is an art. The head movement, when somebody's throwing a shot, you need to be able to move out of the way. Reaction time, so you're constantly having somebody throw something at you, you're moving out of the way. It's all about muscle memory, getting everything ready, so you don't have to think when you're in a fight, you just do.
As far as Liam's kicks, man, those things are dangerous. You know, it's like if you're getting hit by that, it's like a wrecking ball. At first it was just kind of coming out of nowhere, and whatever it hit, it was just doing damage to. So I've kind of tightened it up a little bit and just made it a little bit more accurate. You know, we do a lot of focus on maximizing the technique of it, just so he's not wasting any energy just hitting an elbow or a knee and hurting himself. So you know, you get that leg up there and a big boy like Liam lands upside your head, you're gonna be waking up asking what happened.
Unlike many tall MMA fighters, McGeary is as comfortable on the mat as he is on his feet. This is thanks to years of dedication learning the precise art of jiu-jitsu.
With UFC and Bellator and MMA in general, the wrestler is more of a dominant fighter because they're used to doing the grapple and they're used to being on top. Being English, we never really got brought up with the American way of looking at wrestling. So I've trained jiu-jitsu and my jiu-jitsu is good. So I come against a good wrestler, then my jiu-jitsu, I can play with my jiu-jitsu.
I work with a lot of top jiu-jitsu black belts. And he's something special when it comes to the ground game. He can bring his legs up and over and wrap around you in ways that other guys can't. What works well for him is he's in that position and the guy's on top like, yo, I got him, you know, and he relaxes and it kind of works, you know, against him because he's like, I got my guy where I want him to be. And then he kind of, you know, lets his guard down for one split second, and then Liam slaps something on and the fight's over.
McGeary's most effective submission move is his bespoke inch-perfect lock, the inverted triangle.
His arm will be across his neck, and my leg will be coming in this way and coming across this way and locking up in a figure four. And it forms a triangle around the neck. And that's it. Lights out.